infinite geometric series, a la Shmoop. Pepe holds the world record as the fastest pizza-eating human. Back in 2010, he inhaled 10 slices in 60 seconds. He was crowned the Pizza King and has held the record ever since. Those were the glory days. Glory days. But in the years since, he has let himself go. He can barely muster the motivation to make his way to the phone to order one. Still, he finds a way. One day, he is sitting in a pizza joint with some friends when he's challenged to a pizza-eating contest by an unknown stranger. Pepe wants to relive the glory days, but he isn't sure he has what it takes. Just to be safe, he first eats half a pizza, then 1/6, 1/18, 1/54, and so on. If he keeps eating the pizza this way forever, long time, how much pizza will he have eaten in total? Well, first let's look at the numbers we have. 1/2, 1/6, 1/18, 1/54, and so on. Looks like we have something called a series, or actually, since we're assuming he'll eat forever, an infinite series. But let's take a closer look at the numbers and notice a pattern. Between the first two terms, 1/2 and 1/6, there's a ratio of 1/3. Between 1/6 and 1/18, we have the same ratio of 1/3. That is, we multiply the first by 1/3 and we get the second. Between 1/18 and 1/54, yeah, same ratio, the third. We can call this number 1/3 the common ratio, or R, of the series. Because the terms of the series are separated by a constant ratio, we can describe the series even more specifically as an infinite geometric series. Got that? Now that we've identified the type of numbers we're dealing with and the common ratio between them, let's get back to the problem. If we want to find the total amount of pizza Pepe ate, we should add all the slices together and find the sum. But wait, if he's eating infinite slices, how can we find a finite sum? Doesn't he keep eating forever and ever and ever? No worries, Pepe. The sum of an infinite geometric series has a finite sum as long as the absolute value of the common ratio is less than 1. Think about that. In this case, the absolute value of 1/3 is 1/3, which is less than 1. As you can see from the series above, the numbers are getting smaller and smaller. 1/54 would go to 1 over 162, which is getting closer and closer to 0, see? So as you add smaller and smaller numbers, the addition of such smaller numbers doesn't matter much. Like he's eating a pizza the size of an olive after 5 iterations. Okay, so let's find that total for Pepe. The formula for the sum of an infinite geometric series equals the first term divided by the quantity 1 minus the common ratio. But let's see how this bakes out. Substituting our pizza values into the formula, we see that the sum will equal 1/2 divided by the quantity 1 minus 1/3. 1 minus 1/3 equals 2/3, so we're left with 1/2 divided by 2/3. Stop a sec, be sure you understand this. Instead of dividing 1/2 by that nasty fraction, 2/3, let's multiply by its reciprocal, 3 over 2, to get 1/2 times 3/2, or 3/4. There you go. That'll be 3/4 of a pizza. You can do that, right, Pepe? We have faith in you. Here's the water, and the Pepto-Bismol, and the barf bag. Blech.
Oh, pizza, I'll always love you.